third circle, filled with cold, unending, heavy, and accursed rain. Its measure and its kind had never changed. Gross hailstones, water gray with filth, and snow come streaking down across the shadowed air. The earth, as it receives that shower, stinks. Over the souls of those submerged beneath that mess is an outlandish, vicious beast, his three throats barking dog-like. Cerberus. His eyes are blood red, greasy black his beard. His belly bulges and his hands are claws. His talons tear and flay and rend the shades.
The third circle of hell is the circle of the gluttons. And gluttons are treated like pigs in this circle of hell. They lay down under a disgusting rain and they roll in mud like literally pigs. But it's not that these people are totally deprived of their humanity.
Oh, you, who are conducted through this hell. Recall me, if you can. The name you citizens gave me was Jocko. And for the damning sin of gluttony, as you can see, I languish in the rain.
The person that Dante meets here in the circle of the gluttons is Jocko. Jocko was a glutton, okay. But Jocko is also the person who explains to Dante the moral corruption of Florence. So he speaks with dignity about what's going on in their city.
As one of the dead, Jocko has knowledge of what the future holds and is thus able to tell Dante of the horrific violence that will soon take place between the warring factions in Florence. The greed and corruption of whose unjust leaders has long since caused the city to descend into a hell of warring appetites.
After long controversy, they'll come to blood. The uncouth party will chase the other out with much offense. But then, within three suns, they too must fall, at which the other party will prevail. Two men are just, but no one listens to them. Three sparks that set on fire every heart. Our envy, pride, and avariciousness.